And now, Fairlawn High School proudly presents Merrily We Roll Along.
Merrily we roll along, roll along, bursting with dreams.
Traveling's the fun,
flashing by the countryside.
Everybody merrily, merrily,
catching at dreams.
Rolling along.
Everybody run.
you get to be here? Pick yourself a road, get to know the countryside. Soon enough you'll merrily, merrily practice in dreams. Leaves that will explode, waking up the countryside, making you feel merrily, merrily. What can go wrong?
Tyler here is the man who invented the telephone answering machine.
People are living in fear. I'll invent something else.
Bad prank.
So what do you do?
He's full of bad boys.
I drink.
Bad prank.
What do you really?
And God is being nice.
I really drink. What a friend, what a host.
And his work is great.
Has a wife who is gorgeous.
A son who's straight. He's the type you can easily learn to hate. Bad prank.
Says lonely at the top. I say let it never stop. It's our time coming through. All our dreams coming true. Working hard, getting rich, being happy. There is a switch.
That smile.
He's
hot, but he's cool.
That was the old Frank Shepard.
One style. If you had no idea of charisma meant, and you just can't be jealous, he's such a gent. He's the kind of a man that you can't resent. That Frank.
Franklin.
Meg, this is Mary Flynn. Mary is my deepest, closest, best friend in all the world. We go way back.
But seldom forward. Actually, Franklin gave me the novel you wrote, and I read it over and over.
Didn't you get it the first time?
Hey, gang, we got this orchestra and dancing inside.
Can we go for a little dancing?
I said, Frank, you're coming down to Mexico.
Frank is moving back to Paris.
These are the movers, these are the shapers, these are the people that feel the papers.
Mexico.
These are the friends of
Frank, and back to Paramount.
Each one a perfect blend.
When you see a movie that's successful, what can you say?
Congratulations!
Thank you!
These are the movers, these are the shapers, these are the people that give you vapors.
20 years ago, who'd have guessed? Who'd have guessed we'd be standing here? God, we would have been so impressed. Now we're here with the most
Mexico
brilliant minds on the coast.
Moving back to Paris.
Notice who is their host.
Mexico, beautiful friend. Acapulco, Mexico, beautiful friend. When you see a movie that's successful, where do you go?
Paramount? Here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn few. Thanks, pal, for flying out.
Thanks, pal, for the ticket. I got a letter from Frankie.
At least my son writes to you.
To thank me for coming to his graduation.
He didn't invite me.
He didn't invite me either.
How is Frankie?
He asked the same thing about you. Frank, can't the two of you just...
Frank! I'm beginning my broadcast, where Franklin Shepherd goes Aga, because that's where the A-list goes.
I just figured out what the A stands for.
Now I heard a reliable rumor that you're selling the Malibu house.
Oh, you don't want it. The place doesn't even have a pool.
No pool? In my rat's hole in New York, the John is terminally busted and the kitchen should be condemned, but no pool? Terrific!
Let's have some coffee, Mary.
Poor
Frank.
I never drink coffee.
He handled that well.
Caffeine isn't good for you.
Bad Frank.
Look, I'm aware this was just a formula movie, but my next picture, you wait.
I gave up
waiting. Life in silver, rain or shine.
It began when I tasted communion wine.
Bad Frank.
Who says mustn't go too far? I say look at where we are. It's our time coming through. I say good, me and you. I say roll, I say ride. I say hey, there's food inside.
That's
right,
you're
moving
his
mind.
You think he relaxed? Public
box.
Ah, Frank, he's laying new tracks.
Frank,
if you have no idea what charisma meant, then you just can't be jealous, he's such a gent. He's the kind of a man to be president. That Frank.
And what do we see in front of us? A rising star! Because no matter what the critics say about the picture, they're certain to love you.
Oh, they're certain to, no matter what they're saying about the picture.
The plot thins.
Meg, you know my wife, Gussie?
Everybody who's ever been to a Broadway show knows Gussie Carnegie.
Oh, the hem of your garment.
I say by tomorrow, all of that is going to be at your feet.
Scotty, that's the valley.
Have you been inside all this time?
It's customary when you give a party to attend it.
Did you sing?
No one asked.
Franklin!
Later.
You're ignoring me.
Yes, I am.
I've got feelings.
And I've got a wife.
I love you so much.
And I love you.
Well, I'm off. Tomorrow I fly to New York.
Oh, and while you're out there, don't miss the new Charles Pringles play. It's the only show in years that actually deserves its Pulitzer Prize. I say in every generation there's always one playwright. Oh my God, what did I say?
Don't you know that in this joint you must never ever mention the name Charles Kringis?
Mary?
You see, Charlie, Frank, and I were once these devoted, inseparable
Would anyone
friends,
care to come
up
inside?
Up until that famous television show when Charlie in front of everybody
Mary, God damn it, that's enough.
Mary, I've warned you.
Hey, the house numbers are in from the East Coast.
And it went to the roof.
So we don't have to save the bottles for deposits.
And you, listen. The real surprise of Darkness Before Dawn is Meg Kincaid, a starry-eyed fawn.
To Franklin Shepherd, with whom I started out in that crummy little Greenwich Village saloon.
To Franklin Shepherd, congratulations to the client that every lawyer dreams of. 40 years old, a hit in New York, and now a hit in Hollywood. Married to this Broadway legend, surrounded by the people who work for him. By his money.
Or are we making speeches? To Franklin Shepherd, the producer, to the man who has everything. And fat, drunk, and finished, I'd rather be me any day.
Look at the time. I've got to get to bed.
He'll wait. Get out of here, drunk.
Gussie.
Get that fat sot out of here.
Mary, may I take your glass?
No, Big Shy, you may not take my glass. Oh, no. Now I won't be invited back here anymore. Now, don't y'all feel you have to leave just because I'm leaving. But first, attention. I said attention! I have something I must say. You are all junk. And you deserve them.
Damn sad.
Who was she?
She's a critic.
She wrote a bestseller once.
I would have never believed it. She's finally out of Frank's life.
And the loss is unbearable.
Ow!
What happened? She cut her hand on a piece of glass.
It's nothing. It will stop.
Meg's cut her hand rather badly.
Honestly, it's nothing.
Somebody, Rue, go get something. Get some iodine.
See, when you're young and the star, how the slightest thing and you're everybody's focus.
Bitch.
It's stopping. I'm just gonna let it air. You two certainly know how to bring down a curtain.
You've got the iodine? Where's the patient?
She's down at the foot of the lawn.
Doing her fawn imitation.
Mr. Shepherd?
Frank.
Before I go, I'd like to know, how do I get to be you?
The worst vice in the world is advice, so I don't give any. Hey! Don't just write what you know. Write what you know. Get out of here.
The worst vice is advice? Did you get that off a t-shirt, Frank?
I'm sorry. What's wrong now?
You and that little bitch, that's what's wrong.
Please, please don't do this. We've got a party going on in there.
You may have betrayed me, but you are not going to humiliate me.
Gussie, when are you going to let it go? I never said you were too old for the part. The studio said you were too old for the part.
To think I divorced a husband who worshipped the ground I walked on to marry a pitiful excuse for a man like you.
I've only made one mistake in my life, but I've made it over and over and over. And that was saying yes when I meant no. Forgive me.
Don't you dare walk away from me, mister.
All right. You want to know if it's true? It's true. What you would never understand is that she is sensitive. She cares. She's an inspiration. She's the raft that keeps me from drowning.
Pathetic. After all these years, I have to hand it to Charlie Kringis. That driven little runt was the only one smart enough to read your label.
I envy Charlie Kringis every day of my life.
Oh, hilarious. This coming from the man whose work isn't remembered by the time the audience has reached the parking lot.
I swear, if I could go back to the beginning, if I could somehow be writing shows with Charlie, trying to change the world, I would give all this up like that.
You've lied to yourself so long that you probably believe that.
Do you really not see that I am ashamed of all this? That I am as sick of myself as you are? To not let people see how much I hate my life and how much I wish the goddamn thing was over!
I found her running across the lawn, singing.
Sorry, here.
My significant other and I want to say goodnight.
Oh, Meg. My husband was just telling me how you're the starry-eyed little slut that keeps him from drowning.
Gussie, stop it!
Absolutely, Frank. I will stop it. But maybe she won't be so starry-eyed!
No!
There's my daughter!
To be here.
1973.
NBC Studios, New York City, 1973.
We had a good thing going, going, gone.
And that was Frank Sinatra singing Good Thing Going from the Broadway and film hit, Musical Husbands. The composers of that show, Franklin Shepard and Charles Kringas, are here in our studio tonight, and we'll be meeting and talking with them. But first, the news. Hallie?
The lead-in story from tonight's edition of News from New York. Today, our nation is at long last celebrating the ceasefire in Vietnam, the tragic death toll now having cost nearly 46,000 American lives. Judy?
On the local front, Mayor Abe Beam.
Well, Mr. Kringas, what do you think?
I think my worst nightmare has come true. I look like Richard Nixon.
Charlie!
Charlie.
Mary, do not speak to me. This whole goddamn thing is your fault. I don't know why in Christ's name I let you talk me into this humiliation.
Here's the drink you ordered, Miss Flynn.
Mary, how thoughtful.
Charlie, come on. I need a drink.
All right, one drink. What would you like?
A bottle of vodka and a straw. Where's Frank?
Oh, Frank, probably off signing to score another movie or closing another record deal. I only know where Frank never is. That's with me, working on our show.
Well, when I called KT to set up this interview, I made it very clear that all you two were here to talk about was your next show and how long you both have been working on it.
Throw up. Mary, ever since Frank married Gussie, the only working he knows is working the room.
And just where did he learn that, huh, Charlie? Off on that goddamn yacht is where? And who was it who sent him off on that goddamn yacht, huh?
Well, I say to hell with Frank. I started a play all on my own. And if he doesn't show up in the next 30 seconds, for me, I am walking right out that door.
Charlie, I know Frank. If you connect with him again, if you commit the guy today publicly, I promise by tomorrow you two will be back working together again. You gotta help save him, Charlie. Hey, old friend, what do you say? Old friend, make it okay. Old friend, give the old friendship a break. Why so grim? We're going on forever. You, him, too many lives are at stake. Friends, this long has to mean some things strong. So if our old friend's wrong, shouldn't an old friend come through?
Things were easier than trouble.
After all these years, you're still in love with the guy.
You gotta help save me then, Charlie.
Charlie, Frank, we're at a commercial break and then it's us.
And Frank isn't here.
He isn't here? Where the hell is Frank?
Frank is here and Frank is sorry, but ever since Gussie and I got married, life is the series of meetings. Hey, pal.
Hey, pal, long time no see.
Buddy, did I miss you. And Mary. Oh, God, Mary. You look wonderful. You lost a little weight.
180 pounds. He still calls, though.
Please, Frank, in the chair. And Charlie, you come with me.
KT, I think I saw my ex-husband hovering around outside. Could you see to it that no one is allowed in? He's become the eternal sponge.
Move, please. We've got to go.
Excuse me, Mrs. Shepherd. I know this is inappropriate, but I wrote this new film script, Darkness Before Dawn. That is so perfect for you.
It is inappropriate. Give it to me. I've accepted that if I don't want people handing me scripts, I can never go out. Have you talked to Mary about the 3-picture deal yet?
Oh, no.
But please, let me be the one to tell Charlie. I'm waiting for the exact moment.
Oh, God.
I've explained to Frank. You can compose a Broadway show and you're something in New York. But if you produce a movie, you're something all over the world.
Please, Frank, we're up. We've got to move.
Oh, hell.
Gussie. Hi, Gussie.
Oh, Joe.
You look great.
You've caught me in the middle, Joe.
Listen, I was just wondering if you could spare 100 or so.
Joe, you can't keep doing this to me, Joe. This is the last time.
I'm lining up backers for my next show.
Excuse me, Joe. They're waiting for me.
And now, our evening's top news story. The Supreme Court has finalized its ruling legalizing abortion. The court stated, abortion should be a decision between a woman and her physician. A long-time controversy now ended. Judy?
Took for granted a lot, and still I say, it could have kept on going.
For those of you who are tuning in late, that's Frank Sinatra singing the hit song by Franklin Shepard and Charles Pringus. Our next guests, live from New York.
Oh, and Frank, I can't thank you enough for this favor.
A favor? After what you did for me during my divorce?
Oh, that's why we're here.
Oh, and how is your son?
You want to see a picture?
No. But choose it on the air, and I'll coo, and I'll tear, and I'll carry on like a mad thing. People love cheap sentiment. Oh, and I understand congratulations are in order. I hear you've signed a 3-picture deal to produce movies.
Where'd you hear that?
Oh, I have my spies. But don't worry, I know I'm not supposed to bring it up on the air.
I think you weren't supposed to bring it up in front of me.
Oh.
Charlie, I was waiting for the exact moment to tell you, but this doesn't change our plans. It's going to be 2 or 3 months at a time. Charlie, I haven't even signed a contract yet. Charlie, I have a son to support, an ex-wife draining me. What happens if we finish this show, get it on, and they say it's no good?
I've got 4 kids to support, and I don't give a rat's ass what they say. If I say it's good, if you say it's good, that's what's important. That's
hey
all
guys,
that's important. He only knows it's good if it makes a freaking fortune.
Hi, we're back. And welcome to Today in New York Celebrity Spot. And here next to me, we have 2 brilliantly talented people. The man on my far left is...
Franklin Shepard. Almost forgot.
And he is. And why should he lie? And I have no idea who I am.
This is my great friend and even greater collaborator, Charlie Pringus.
They are the songwriters for Musical Husbands, both the show and the movie. They also wrote Sweet Sorrow, and their newest collaboration will be called Take a Left. But more about that later.
Apparently much later.
And you recently married the star of those shows, Gussie Carnegie. Did you not?
Yes, that's correct.
And I'm married to Evelyn.
So all of Broadway, the 2 of you are the next Rodgers and Hammerstein, Lerner and Lowe.
Irving and Berlin.
So let's start from the beginning. So you're both from Chicago, and you both went to the same school and the same college.
No, me Columbia, him Juilliard.
So your entire life you've been very, very close friends.
Until today.
Like all partners, we've had our fights and other commitments, but the magic is only there when it's me and Charlie, Charlie and me.
I love it! So now tell me, how do you two work together?
Oh, may I answer that?
Please!
How do we two work together?
Sure.
Well, he goes. And I go. And soon we're humming along. And that's called writing a song. Then he goes. And I go. And the phone goes. And he goes. Butter. Yes, Jerome. Butter. No, Jerome. Butter. That's the boy, Jerome. Butter. You're Jerome. Like, sorry, Charlie. So I go. And he goes. And I go. And soon we're tapping away. Sorry, Charlie. The secretary on the intercom. Yes,
the messenger.
Thank you. Can you tell him to wait? Can you order the car? Can you call up the bank? Can you wire the post? Can you ring? Sorry, Charlie. Mother, sell the stock. Buy the right. Mother, put you on hold. Yes,
the interview.
Tell him to wait. Can you order the car? Can you wire the post? Can you set up the bank? Tell him to print and the stocks get sold. And the rest of us, he keeps on holding since he's making movies. And he's now a corporation. Right? So I play at home with my wife and kids. And I wait to hear the movie bits. And I got the sailboat and I'm into meditation. Right? He flies home to California. I discuss him with my shrink. That's the story of the way we work. Me and Franklin Shepherd, Inc. I'm surprised at how much I'm enjoying this. I promise to be honest if you promise to handle the lawsuit.
Now I've been curious. When you do work together, which generally comes first? The words or the music?
Generally, the contract.
Well, that sounds like you think making money is a bad thing for an artist.
Money? Did I say money? No, I like money a lot. I mean, it's better than not. But when it's money, when it's money. And you should be. Listen, Frank does the money thing very well, but just what? Other people do it better. And Frank does the music thing very well. You know what? No one does it better. Still, the telephone's blinking, the buzzer's buzzing. I really don't know what he does, but he makes a ton of money. And a lot of it for me. Right? So I think, okay, I start a play, but he somehow knows, cause right away it's ring! Hi, everybody, wanna write a show? Got a great idea, we'll own all the rights, but a 2-week out, and a turnaround, and I guarantee I'm a gross percent of the billing cost! And there I am in California, talking deals and drinking. Back in business, and I mean just that. Back with Franklin Shepherd, Inc. Very sneaky how it happens. Much more sneaky than you think. Starts with nothing but a song to sing. Next to Franklin Shepherd. Wait, one moment, please. Let's see.
Now, Franklin, let me ask
getting
you.
Getting too deep here.
Now, Frank.
See, the thing is, we're not that kind of close anymore. The way we used to be. And a friendship is like a garden. You have to water it. End it? And care about it? And you know what? I miss it, and I want it back. Look. Here. Nothing permanent has happened. Just a temporary kink. Friendship, something you don't really lose. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't let me lose the greatest composer any lyricist ever had. Phone him Write him. Stop him on the street. You'll recognize him. He's the one going through his check for. And tell that man to get back to his piano. Very sneaky how it happens. Every day you're on break. First the prizes and the interviews. Oh my God, I think it happened! Stop me quick before I sink. One more triumph that I can't refuse. In case you didn't notice, my first time on TV. And my last, here's the point, whatever happens. Then we'll all go have a drink. That's the guy I love, the fellow who's inside. About a picture of the president. There's a crazy man on my TV screen. Inside. Screen. Inside Franklin Shepherd. Just write in care of any bank, U.S. Inc.
Let's take a commercial break. Oh, thanks, guys. Jesus Christ.
That was a real slaughter, Charlie. Congratulations.
Frank?
Oh, I think you've said enough. I know for years you've been attacking me and constantly putting me in the position of having to defend myself, but that... See, I don't know why anyone in the world would want to humiliate and betray the guy who is his oldest friend in the world like that. But I do know you're never gonna have the opportunity to do it again. You're goddamn out of my life, Charlie.
Frank, I'm sorry!
You're sorry! After you publicly mock and ridicule and belittle me when I swear, man, I will lay down my life for you! Shut up! Charlie, all these years I have loved you no matter what you did, but I guess because I don't live my life like you or the way you want me to, you had to shoot me down and watch me bleed. Well, I like my life, so please, you just get the hell out of it.
Guys, what do you say we go out for a humongous drink and talk? We need to talk.
Frank, are you all right?
You know, there's this tribe in Africa that when one of its members does something cruel or evil or betrays them, they never see him again. They simply just never see him. They never look at him or talk to him or acknowledge him in any way. To them, he is dead. Absolutely and irrevocably dead.
Frank, if I could just explain what all that came out.
Frank, Charlie, stop it! Frank, Charlie, no! No, no!
Central Park West, 1968.
You say she is not there. Is she expected back? You don't expect... I'm sorry, my front doorbell's ringing. The door is open. One more time. You don't expect her back until after the theater. No, no message. Wait, yes, will you tell her that... Oh, Frankie, oh my... Frankie, did your daddy miss you? Give Daddy a love. Bigger.
Daddy, we saw your boat, but we didn't see you.
Ta-da! What's amazing is we're not all still waiting at the dock to surprise you with our face red.
First class doesn't get off at the dock. We had this ramp at the prow and a captain who leads you right to your limousine.
Oh, of course. Silly us. Now you should have known that, Mary. Anyway, we got Beth to send Frankie from Houston.
Daddy, I have 32 postcards all over my wall. My favorites are the alligator in the Panama Canal.
Oh, look, he brought Frankie back an alligator. Now, it's...
Thanks, Charlie. Bound to give someone here real nice dreams.
start with the trip, and then I want a Sherpa guide to show me this gargantuan apartment.
Well, I owe it all to you guys for making me go. I didn't do anything that wasn't rich. Rich food, rich living, rich people.
Well, poor Evelyn, my poor wife, who never comes in from our poor house in the poor country, poor thing, is dropping off our four poor children at her poor mother's.
Got it, Charlie.
We're there expecting Frankie, and then Evelyn is meeting the three of us.
Wait. Where? You'll never guess where.
The downtown club.
Charlie!
Let me think. A smoky, dingy Greenwich Village dive, or the homecoming party at the Colony Club.
Oh, what a sorry, choice. Sorry, Frank. You must give me a list of what is in and what is out. You know how important all that is to me.
Oh, wait. I almost forgot. Presents!
Yay, presents!
This one's for Aunt Mary, and this is for Uncle Charlie. Son, about 40 of yours right now are up in the air between Gibraltar and Texas, but trust me, they're worth the wait.
It's my book. In Spanish.
I bought it in Valparaiso, Chile, where there it was in all the store windows.
Oh, Mary, tell Frank the story of how your success has affected you. Okay, I'll start. Mary has joined the enemy.
Charlie!
Frankie, tell Aunt Mary how many kids in your class say, when I grow up, I want to be a drama critic.
Charlie, shut your mouth and open your present.
I did.
What is it?
It's an option agreement. We've been offered a small fortune to do a movie version of Musical Husbands.
Frankie, take this over to your daddy and say very clearly, there isn't enough money in the universe.
I appreciate the gratitude, Charlie. You're welcome.
There isn't enough money in the universe!
Sweetheart, will you put that on the bed for Uncle Charlie?
Okay.
And then you gotta brush your teeth, wash your face, put on your pajamas, whatever the hell kids do.
Charlie, I'm 31. Beth wiped me out with the divorce. I have a son to support. So forgive me, Charlie, if I happen to need some money.
Let us do the work and the money will come. Frank, we cannot keep making our stuff the other thing we do.
Guys, shh, not now.
Charlie, we can make a statement with this movie.
Nurse, doctor, guard, matron, attendant, anybody help?
Trust me.
No, Frank, you trust me.
Charlie, listen.
No, Frank, you listen. You listening? No, never, ever, no.
Hey! Here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn you.
Hey, old friend, are you okay? Old friend, what do you say? Old friend, are we or are we unique? Time goes by, everything else keeps changing. You and I, we can continue next week. Most friends fade, or they don't make the grade. New ones are quickly made, and in a pinch, sure they'll do. But us, old friend, what's to discuss, old friend? Who's like us? Damn for you.
So, old friend, fill me in slow. Old friend, start from hello. Old friend, I want the win, where at town. Old friends do tend to become old habits. Never knew how much I missed it.
Most friends fade, or they don't make the grade.
New ones
are quickly made. Some of them were something too. But us old friends, what's to discuss, old friend? Tell you something, good friends. Point out your lies, whereas old friends live and let live.
Good friends, like an advice, whereas old friends love and forgive.
And old friends let you go.
Joe must see Frank's new apartment. Did you see that disaster he was living in?
I decorated it.
I'm calling the Surgeon General tomorrow to have him cut out my tongue.
Promises.
Oh, look, Joe, it's Charles. Now we can call the net a success.
Hi, Gussie. I didn't even hear a doorbell.
I bet that's because I didn't ring one. I never do when I have keys. I am decorating this pad. The price was right. Free! Here. I picture all the furniture in this room in hues of anemones. A chair, a footstool, and a sofa. Oh, I should have a brain transplant. I almost forgot we brought this teeny tiny little housewarming nothing. Some awesomely expensive champagne. I'll open it. Do. All right, I will.
Let me go check inside.
Always good to see you, Joe. And your wife.
Joe, precious. There are glasses in the kitchen and it's Frank's house, so he'll do the honors. Mushy, mushy, darling, we've got a curtain to make.
Home one day and she's already ordering me around.
How nice to see the old gang. Can they see us?
Yes.
I haven't even unpacked. I made up my mind. I'm leaving, Joe.
He'll be destroyed.
Or I will be. I'll call when I arrive at the theater.
I'm supposed to go out.
Oh, please, please, you've got to wait for my call.
Gussie.
I'm desperate.
I'll wait for your call.
Consider yourself kissed.
You've got this guy. Everything anyone could ever want in the kitchen, except for glasses.
Here, I'll get them. They're still packed.
Oh, eek. Look at me. That means don't. I'm going to the little boy's room to repair.
It's real first-class champagne.
Oh, I don't drink.
What, never?
Well, hardly ever. I'm a very excessive personality. Too much coffee, too much food, too much cigarettes.
Too much Frank.
Is Frank the only guy in this whole world who doesn't know you're in love with him? How many know about those two?
Well, there are about one or two who don't.
I decided not to know. She's Broadway's hottest star, and the guy, he's hot too. More than one way, obviously. I say, just let them get out of their system, you know? As long as, please God, she don't leave me.
I think Frank's been gone the last 8 months put an end to it.
Gussie flew over and joined the cruise, you know.
What? We had no idea Gussie was on the cruise.
It will never cease to amaze me how everyone in this town knows everything I do. It was only for the last 2 weeks.
Here, pretend these are champagne glasses.
All right, you've got yours, Charlie. Just one, Joe. Mary?
No, thank you.
Oh, that's right. You never do. Oh, well, more for us. To our genius.
Thank you. It's always nice to be appreciated. Curtain, Gus. Curtain. We got a curtain to make.
Oh, poo, but 1 minute late and got every column.
Frank, we'll see you after.
Frank's coming with us.
Oh?
Actually, what I should do is stay here and get organized.
You're kidding me, aren't you?
Oh, Mary, we should all let Franklin get settled in. Good night, Mr. All Work and No Play. And everybody's favorite Charlie.
Don't you guys stay strangers now.
Good night.
You're really not coming.
I can't, not tonight, Mary. Just accept that, will you?
Please, Frank. Please. Here's to us.
Mary.
Come on, Charlie, let's drop Frankie off and let's go have ourselves one hell of a time.
I'll be down in a minute.
Get rid of Gussie, Frank.
Gussie's none of your business, Charlie.
No, but you are. Get rid of this pathetic life.
Charlie, I love success. I love having 2 out of 2 shows hit moving up in the world. I need some time to think.
Well, then begin by thinking about joining Mary and me. Frank, there's something going on with Mary. Ever since her book took off, she hasn't written a word. She needs us. She needs both of us.
I made a promise I'd wait for a phone call. I have to, I promise.
Then take your phone call and get out of it once and for all. And meet us?
I'll be there.
You know, I love you.
I love you.
I missed you.
I missed you.
And I want us to get back working together.
Get out of here before the both of us start wailing.
Good night, Pop, and listen to Uncle Charlie, because he's never wrong.
I'll see you in a few. Miss him already. Charlie won't bend. Charlie's in your corner. Mary is a dreamer. Mary's a friend. Mary is a nudge. Mary is a purist. Charlie's a judge. Charlie is a dropout. Everything's a cop-out. Why is it old friends don't want old friends to change? Every road has a turning, and that's the way you keep learning. Have it all.
on getting out of the past. Solving dreams, not just trusting them, taking dreams, readjusting them, growing up. Growing up. Trying things, being flexible, bending with the rope. Adding dreams when the others don't last. Growing up, understanding that growing never ends. Like old dreams, some old dreams, like old friends.
Back here.
Gussie, I'm supposed to go out. I have to meet Mary and Charlie, and there's something I have to tell
Frank,
you.
I did it. I sent the driver back to take my things to a hotel.
Gussie, you can't. We've already destroyed one marriage. I can't live with you leaving Joe for
I'm
me.
I'm leaving him for me.
But why? Why suddenly? Why
because
tonight?
Because I saw tonight I could lose you.
My friends are waiting.
Your friends will be there for you tomorrow. I need you tonight.
Life is knowing what you want, darling. That's the only thing to know. As I told you moons ago, darling, nothing wrong with wanting. Nothing wrong with wanting me, darling. Also nothing wrong with not. Though it's only fair that you should be aware that I want you a lot. Growing up means admitting the things you want the most. Can't pursue every possible it's clearly understood, darling, better go and grab it. Things can slip away for good, darling, what is it you really
May I have the number to the downtown club?
Thank you.
In the case of Shepherd versus Shepherd, after serious consideration, I've made a decision to close this courtroom to both the press and the public. After a one-hour recess, we will reconvene behind closed doors for the next subpoenaed witness. This court is now adjourned.
You missed the star going in. Stay close. We'll try to grab her coming out.
I left the minute the peace march broke. What do you got?
The composer's wife wants every last cent, plus the kid. The cat's gonna be lucky if they let him keep his clothes.
I thought you got something hot.
Once the judge reads the deposition of the star witness and suddenly the courtroom closes to the public, trust me, I got something hot.
It's an innocent little friendship that's been blown totally out of proportion.
Look, you're a big star now. You gotta know better.
Hold it, Miss Carnegie. Why were you subpoenaed?
Financial records percentage, Chastity.
Miss Carnegie, how are the two of you involved in
we
the scandal?
We are not involved.
And it's not a scandal. We have no comment.
Then why were you subpoenaed to testify today?
My wife and me are Mr. Shepherd's best friends.
Do you not understand that we have no comment?
And the public knows no comment means guilty as hell. Any statement for the press, counselor?
I have no statement. Stay with me.
I understand Miss Carnegie is scheduled to testify in a closed courtroom.
That's what we understand.
Why?
We have no idea.
Well, maybe Mr. Shepherd could explain. Is Mr. Shepherd coming out?
Mr. Shepherd just left by a side exit.
I know that exit.
Go get him, Charlie.
Frank? This has gone on long enough.
We all think you should get out of this any way you can.
Give Beth whatever she wants.
Charlie, she wants everything.
I warned you in the beginning, Frank. Settle for whatever, but settle. A woman's charging abandonment of wife and child. Come on.
Beth wants to move back to Houston with my son, and I'll never allow that. Never.
I wonder what they're planning to do in there today, Frank.
With Beth sitting there with your kid on her lap?
Stop it now, Frank. Walk away. Take a trip.
Save yourself all this pain.
I cannot just lose my family.
Frank, I'm taking the yacht. The cruise, get away, get some rest.
And when you get back, you can stay with me.
Go, Frank, go. We all want you out of this. Go, get away.
It's not life without my son. Beth.
Frank, don't make it worse.
I'm not gonna give up, Jerome.
Daddy, wait for me.
Don't be a fool, Elizabeth.
Just wait. Mommy will be right back, okay? You go with Grandpa.
Your mother will turn over in her grave.
I want you to give up, Frank.
It's not life without my son.
Then you're not going to like what you hear this afternoon. I'm not out to hurt you, Frank, but I will hurt you if I have to.
How is Frankie?
How do you think he is, Frank? You know, all I keep thinking is I could have stopped it. I was warned about Gussie. I could have stopped it.
Do you still love me?
Did you sleep with her, Frank?
Do you still love me?
Not a day goes by. Not a single day, but you're somewhere a part of my life, and it looks like you'll stay as the days go by. I keep thinking, just go on thinking and sweating and cursing and crying and turning and reaching and waking and dying and no, not a day goes by, not a blessed day, but you're still somehow part of my life. And you won't go away, so there's hell to pay. And until I die, I'll die day after day after day after day after day after day after day, till the days go by.
Thank you.
that kind of life so much that you went with her.
I'll always love you.
But did you?
Yes.
Frank. I want us to... No, no, Frankie, you're to stay with Brent.
He's my child, too. Get out of here!
I can't live like this!
I said get out of here! You satisfied?
It's my job, man.
Let me get a decent one, man.
Hey, man, I'm down. Cool off.
I'll kill the photos, genius. But you owe me. Listen to Charlie and me, Frank. We want you to get away.
Just hold me close, Mary. All I want to do is get back to work.
You're in no shape to ride, pal. Why don't you go off with Tyler for a while?
I don't want to go away.
I'm your agent, and I'm telling you now is not the time for work. I love you, Frank. And Charlie loves you. Listen to us.
Living well, that's the best revenge.
So you've made a mistake, so you've seen that blue, so you'll take some time, go visit some place.
You gotta be somewhere where there's nothing to remind you, right?
What you need is a break.
I'll arrange a nice cruise, relax a bit, and see some new faces.
You've gotta do something, but just never look behind you. Right?
Best thing that ever could.
Yeah.
he loves what I can do for him. Maybe he thinks that I'll come through for him. Maybe the moon is cheese, and yet maybe, maybe something real is happening here. But baby, you're a baby, and the man I married to needs me here. Okay, the moon is cheese.
Or did you forget?
We're sorry. We're very sorry. But something amazing happened.
Well, I'll say amazing when suddenly, just before the 11 o'clock number, this whole package jumps straight up out of your seats, turns around, and runs straight down the center aisle like a bunch of machigana.
It was Evelyn. All of a sudden, just like that, went into labor.
And being Evelyn, she wouldn't tell us until her pains were only 5 minutes apart. We just a second ago got her into the cab.
Then what the hell are you doing here?
Oh, my wife wouldn't let me into the cab.
Evelyn refused to let Charlie miss our first opening night.
We even brought a tape recorder to record the applause.
From your mouth to God's ear.
All right, Charlie, as soon as the applause is over, I have a cab waiting that's going to take you, Beth, and I right to that hospital in record time, I promise.
They're quiet.
Very quiet.
When an audience is quiet like that, it means they're really concentrating. Shut up, Mary.
Listen, we should go back in for the close-up. I didn't mean the closing! Oh.
Now, Daddy, that cab right there with the meter running, that one's for Charlie, so you and Mommy go in the one right behind it, okay? And we both love you very much, and we both thank you very much. Now hurry!
I don't understand why in hell any human being in his right mind
would ever live in New York City.
Charlie, let's do another show.
Yeah, and then another, and another, and another.
And I'll produce.
Now, wait a minute. Joe, you'll produce Take a Left?
Well, I say you make yourself a couple of hits to show you can make money. Then we can do that political flop you want to do to show you've got integrity. Me, I got such the idea for you guys. So commercial. First you'll hate it, but then you'll love it.
Now you know I never say anything, but I'm going to say this. For me, just do one more for Joe, and then you can do Take a Left.
I know the kind of music I want to write, and I know this is hard on you now, but Beth, I'm asking you to trust me.
And I'm asking you to trust me. Beth, guys, right now's the time. You gotta do your own stuff. Oh, but you don't have a child, Mary, and you just had yourself a bestseller, so it's all really easy for you to say.
Believe me, Beth, success ain't all it's cracked up to be.
I think Charlie and I will handle success very well.
Oh, yeah, look how well we've handled failure.
Listen to that. Will you listen to that?
Do you know what that means? Let me tell you what that means. Wait, no, anyone who even thinks it, don't say it, you'll jinx it.
Listen to that.
Did you listen to that?
Does that make you feel proud? Or feel more than just proud? Okay, wait, I'll tempt fate and I'll stay out loud. That's the sound of a hit. It's a hit, gang. I think this is it. for little shows for those basement salons. No more proclamations from the pros that you can't hum the tune.
No more sneaking in an intermission to the place you wish you could afford.
Or producers having you audition whenever they're bored.
And sing right away as you play the first chord. Boys, boys, that was very, what is the word? Interesting. And if I had any belief any audience would come to see it, I would produce it in a minute. Next!
We're a hit!
Standing up the whole bit!
No more coaching those sopranos with voices like me.
No more secondhand pianos with six broken keys.
No more agents giving you opinions as they turn you over to their minions.
Just for these guarantees, we should please thank the Lord. It's a hit!
So my folks have a fit after all of that baloney. They've made me go through all that. Tell you not that he's a phony, but what does he do? Will their faces be stony when they see on their Sony someone handing the phony that Tony award?
I would like to begin by thanking all of the hundreds of people who have turned down every show I have ever written so that I could win tonight for this one. Thank you. Listen to that. Will you listen to that? Tell me, is that a noise or is that a noise? That is a noise we've been waiting the whole of our lives to hear.
Listen to that,
listen to that.
Honey, is that a noise or is that a noise? That is the loveliest noise for a bread-winning wife to hear. Listen to that, that's obscene.
Listen to that, that is the noise that is really on the internet. Will you listen to that?
That's the sound of an audience losing its mind. It's the Pope on his balcony blessing mankind.
Folks, it's funny, girl, Fiddler, and Dolly.
It's a hit. It's a palpable hit.
If it only even runs a minute, at least it's a wet. It's the theater and we're really in it, not just on the edge. If your spirits ever need improving, you can drop it any night for free.
But the thing that's positively moving,
you could have fooled me, is we're still old friends. Nothing can kill old friends. Where there's a will, old friends don't need success to survive.
And us, old friends, watching this stars, old friends, we've got a surefire, genuine, walk-away blockbuster, lines out to Broadway, a full, a sensational farce of his love.
Everyone dreams of. Now we go inside and fake being modest.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm having a baby.
We're coming.
Me too.
What about the opening party?
You two go to the party. Frank, I will do one more for Joe Josephson. But just one more.
One more? Then it's our time.
One more. Come on.
Wait a minute. Frank, I was there for Evelyn's first baby, and I want to be there for this one too. But you go ahead.
No, honey, no. Absolutely not. No.
Yes, yes, yes. And I'm so proud of you. If I don't see you at the hospital, I'll see you at home. Oh, I love you so much. Go. Beth. With Gussie there, I urge you to go with Frank. Oh, sometimes you have to trust, Mary.
And sometimes you don't.
I'd never love a man I couldn't trust.
Hey, big guy! You got a ride to this fancy-smancy party?
I can only stay 1 or 2 minutes.
Oh. Was that not why we do all this? Was that not just heaven?
Look, I gotta go make nice with Thackeray's, but you two take the car. I won't be able to afford this big man anymore. You watch.
It's so nice to meet another pure artist. So long I've wanted to thank you, but Franklin Shepherd, I think there's a conspiracy to keep you from me.
Miss Carnegie, I owe you so much.
Didn't I tell you a few years ago it's fate that brought us together? Anyways, all you've been doing these past few months is work, work, work. Tonight, let me show you how divine it is to be number one. Everyone is waiting to meet the man of the hour.
to travel just for the thrill.
Then your dream.
Some roads are easy.
Some
roads are full of jiggles and bumps. Can't let it get you down in the dumps. Don't let it get you down in the dark.
1964. 1962.
Gussie and Joe's Brownstone, New York City, 1962.
Have you seen how was it? You're not serious. Me, that does it. You're not serious.
Have you seen how was it?
You're not serious.
Celebrities. I'm looking for Charlie.
Oh, you can do both. God, I never saw so many famous people.
Ah! What? Who? Where? Oh.
What'd he say?
I haven't talked to him yet, but it's obvious he didn't invite us here because we'd fit in so well. But I am sure more than ever he wants to option our show.
Well, I'm sure too, but not too sure. Look, you're the one who's supposed to handle the business.
I'm handling it, Charlie. You wait. All this time you put into our writing is finally gonna pay off.
Look, I don't care what he asks. You just say yes. All I want is for us to be rich as long as we've been poor.
Beth, there are a lot of sophisticated people here.
Oh, God, if I'd known that, I would have worn earrings.
Come on, let's go.
What's going on?
Those people over there, they're smoking marijuana.
Oh, I've smelled that before. In the village. I thought it was autumn.
Come on.
Darling, we saw the new darling. We had the most bad, it was good, it's the biggest. Well, you can't buy it, you can't miss it out, it's just the thing up.
Hi, I don't know if you remember me. I'm Franklin Shepherd. Oh, and that's Charlie Kringus, who writes my lyrics. Oh, and this is Beth, my wife, Beth.
Remember you? You're the reason we're giving this bash. According to our accountant, anyway. Do you write songs, too?
No, right now I'm the family breadwinner.
You don't mind kidnapping, do you? I have invited the richest and most influential people in this town tonight, but none of whom are as rich or influential as you are going to be. I call them the Blob. They absorb everything. Meet the Blob, the bodies you read about, the ones who know everyone. That everyone knows.
Hi, dreadful fabulous!
Meet the Blob. Not many in the end.
Oh, right!
You never see one.
Wendo!
They come as a set.
Him?
And we're in their debt.
What do you think?
Cause honey bunch, they write the books and put on the shovels and run the cells and design the clothes. They keep us natives on our toes.
I'll be Warhol, Kurosawa.
Then they read the books and go to the shows and swamp the cells wearing all the clothes. What if my car a glut? But they're the most important people in the most important city in the most important country in the you-know-what.
Heavy, real town, Gestalt.
Beth, darling, you don't have any hooch. Oh no, I'm going to open my veins.
Okay, better be since now I own it.
Joe, hurry, we have a gigantic catastrophe. Oh, this is scandalous. Joe, take this gorgeous person up to my closet, and she is going to choose some rag of mine. Move, Joe, please, I am paralyzed with shame.
You've talked to my wife. Listen, we got something in mind, maybe for Broadway.
Joe, if you don't hurry, I'm going to throw myself down the garbage disposal. Now move. Your new songs are just beautiful.
I brought over some newer ones.
You're wonderful.
I just admire people like you so much. You seem to know everyone and do everything.
Yes, I do. One day I just made myself up and now I never change. Instead, I change the people around me. Scotty, precious, this is your new client, Franklin Shepherd.
Oh.
You can give me a holler tomorrow or I can yell on you. I'm in the book.
So am I.
See, look how much you two already have in common.
I just found you an agent.
Joe gave me this greenhouse as a wedding present. He has this tendency to worship me.
It's great.
If you like it, take it home.
I married Joe because he liked me and I liked this life. I married the one before him because, well, I believed him when he said he could write. And the first one? Well, I don't think first ones really count. Do you?
This greenhouse seems as out of place in New York as I do.
Only at first, darling. But now I find it the best thing about this dump. How old are you?
I'm 25, which doesn't bother me, but then I think I'm a quarter of a century, and then I panic. There's so much I want to do, and I can't
get... Here's something I like to do when I want to get to know someone. Very well. Very fast. It's a game. I tell you something honest about me, and you answer me right away with something honest about you. I call it trading hostages. I'm not very happy. Go on, I'm not very happy.
I'm very happy.
I'm inches away from the top.
I am miles away from the top. Make that hundreds of thousands of miles away from the top.
Performing is my life.
Composing is my life.
Success is not happening fast enough.
Success is not happening at all.
I've done 5 Broadway shows.
I've seen the second act of every one.
Someone is cheating. I've done 5 Broadway shows.
Me, I can't get started.
My first love is singing.
My first love is music.
My second love is acting.
My second love is music.
I believe it's fate that brought us together. Anywho, I did all those Broadway shows, most of which didn't last as long as this conversation, and Joe has just optioned a vehicle that can change my life. And yours. We want you and your partner to do the score. Do I see disappointment on that sweet face?
We were hoping he would want to do Take a Left, the show Charlie and I auditioned for him.
Oh no, darling, not at all.
But we worked on it for 3 years.
Well, you can do this one much faster. But he wants me to make sure you understand. We want it fast, loud, and funny. I need a hit. What do you say? Life is knowing what you want. Darling, that's the thing you have to. No, you'll get everything you want. Darling, have a little patience. Climbing mountains can be slow. Darling, take it easy as you climb. I'd say you're a winner, also a beginner. One step at a time. Growing up, it's what they call growing up. It's when we're all starting out and starting to sway. Growing up, you hate the delay. But after today, you'll be on your way. So what do you say?
Okay.
Now the show is not very subtle and it's not big on depth. It's flash, bam, curtain. It's fun, it's opulent, it's Broadway. What was that? A second thought?
Oh, no, that's something I like to do when I want to hold on to a moment. I close my eyes real tight and I swallow. Like taking a picture I can treasure.
You're a treasure.
It's the best, it's the first, it's the finest, it's the latest, it's the least, it's the worst, it's the absolutely lowest, it's the greatest, it's the single, it's the only, it's the perfect, it's the best, it's the first, it's the finest, it's the latest, it's the least, it's the worst.
Who hasn't drunk, smoked, or gorged too much to hurry on over here now. Chop, chop. Frank, oh, Frank, will you look at this?
Honey, it's beautiful. Mary, where have you been?
I had to borrow a dress from the guy upstairs.
Oh, darling. It looks wonderful on you. Keep it. I'm too fat to wear it anyways.
See, this is Mary Flynn. Mary is a copy editor, but real soon she's got her first book coming out.
Sorry I was late. So glad you didn't wait.
See, Frank, Mary, and Charlie are these totally inseparable friends.
Well, I have to separate for 1 minute. I have to find Charlie.
No. I've got plans for you. Mary Flynn, would you be as sweet as you look and go get him Charlie for me? Thank you this much! Your husband is the most talented composer I have ever heard. I hope it's all right. I'm crazy about him.
I hope it's all right, too.
Shh, listen now, because one day you will be able to say, I was there when I have next to me the most talented composer ever, 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 and he is going to play a song he wrote, and when he finishes, you are all going to want to swallow poison because there will be nothing more to live for. So find a place to park it for Ms. All Those Booches, and I am honored to present to you Franklin Shepherd and Charles some funny name. Anyway, this song is from a little show that they want to do that we hope will be in a big show that we want to do.
Big show? Frank, what the hell is she talking about?
Later, sing.
It started out like a song. We started quiet and slow, with no surprise. And then one morning I woke to realize we had a good thing going. It's not that nothing went wrong. Some angry moments, of course, but just a few. And only moments, no more, because we had this good thing going. And if I wanted too much, was that such a mistake at the time? You never wanted enough. All right, tough, I don't make that a crime. While it's going along, you take for granted some love will wear away. We took for granted a lot, but still I say it could have kept on growing instead of just kept on. We had a good
going, gone. Oh! Wait, keep them there. We want to hear it again. Tell them. Wouldn't you all just like to live your entire lives to that music? Okay, down, everybody, down, down, down. They're gonna do it again. One more time.
Frank, no, say no.
Charlie's right.
No, they loved it.
They thought we were great.
Yeah, but you wanna know what true greatness is? It's knowing when to get off.
I'll sing with you. Come on.
It started out like a song. We started quiet and slow, with no surprise. And then one morning I woke to realize
I said, Joe, this should be a watershed.
It's not that nothing went wrong. Some angry
did you hear?
Moments, of course, but just a few.
Not only moments, no more, because we knew
we had a good thing.
Did you show that word of injustice? Did you read it?
And if I wanted to watch it, was that thought of the mistake at the time? You never wanted enough. All right, tough, I don't.
Darling!
By then there'll be Bobby
and Teddy too,
or Peter or Steven
or even you. unknown.
Because each of our kids will ascend the throne.
And their kids have more kids with kids of their own. It's sort of a family knack.
Till most of the nation's made up of relations of Bobby and Jackie and Jack and Ethel and Ted and Eunice and Pat and Joe and Steve and Peter and Jean and Sarge and Joe and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose. The decade is starting anew. And maybe the country is too.
Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of our review, Frankly Frank, now in its fifth successful, not quite record-breaking month, thanks you for coming to the upstairs room at the Downtown Club, where we perform two shows every night, with the exception of tonight. Cut that out. Anyway, come back and bring a friend, or come back and make a friend, or just come back and be a friend. Thank you.
Excuse me. I got really excited when I saw your name on the reservation list, Mr. Josephson. I'm just a waiter here. I actually have three different jobs, but it's only until I can get my adventure launched. You see, I've invented this new machine that can answer the phone when you aren't home. Or even when you are. I just can't seem to get enough investors for it.
Kid, there are already answering services with operators that do for people, guess what, just what you want this Verkakta machine to do.
Now, Mr. Josephson, all I need is $4,000, and for that, I'd sign a contract right here, giving you 50% of the return.
I live in a penthouse, not an asylum. Now, I will invest my last red cent. You come up with a sound idea. Something like this new 3D movie process. When am I gonna find a waiter who's just a waiter?
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Spencer. I'm Mary Flynn. Frank and Beth will be down in a minute. I bet you're excited about the wedding.
Excited is not the word.
You cannot imagine how important Frank is going to be someday.
No, we can't.
Do you work in the show business, too?
No, I'm just a fan. But I've never heard music like Frank's.
Us neither.
I work for Look Magazine.
Now there's a steady and secure job.
I hate it.
Well, maybe that's why they call it work.
Mr. Josephson, do you remember me? I'm Frank Shepherd. Our whole cast was overwhelmed, is what they are, that an important man like you would come down to see our little review.
And you recall Shirley Malinsky? Now Gussie Carnegie? She fixed the nose, she fixed the clothes, she fixed the name. Take a look what was underneath all that.
Oh, you. I used to work part-time as a secretary to pay for classes.
We've all seen and admired you on stage so much.
A big talent wasted on small shows, up until me. But you boys must be doing something right, because the fiance here is going through one hell of a divorce. But you boys made her laugh.
Oh, JoJo, I thought it was just peaches.
Oh, see us, we're usually light years better, but everyone was, God, so nervous that you were here. And it's a pretty nervous night for me, too, getting married.
Is the girl on the show?
Beth.
You're awfully young. Marion Haste, repent and Reno.
I'm 23. The guy who does my lyrics is my age, and he has a baby up. Mr. Josephson, do you remember Charlie Kringis? My collaborator from the time we auditioned for you.
I collabor him, he collabors me.
Mazel tov. Listen, your stuff's getting more commercial, which is good. Because if you're getting married, you're going to need the bucks. Trust me. Now, I say, unless the girl's pregnant, get out of it. Have a good wedding.
You know, I don't forget talented people, Hank.
Frank.
Frank, you know, unless you really want to, you don't have to.
I want to, Charlie.
Frank, if there's any truth at all, we turn out like our parents. You're in big trouble.
Mary, do you think I'm making a wrong decision?
Frank, if you want to know what I think,
Frank. Now, don't faint. My parents want to speak with us before the ceremony. Frank? I'm not pregnant.
What?
Do you still want to get married?
Do you?
Well, before my reason was the baby. But now my reason is you.
My reason is you.
I am pregnant.
Beth!
I just wanted to be sure.
Elizabeth.
How do I look, Mom?
Your father and I just want to say one thing.
You've said it all for 2 days.
The man doesn't even have a real job. My daughter told me she was going back to being a legal secretary just to support you.
Mama, I told you that in private.
Mrs. Spencer, what I want to do with my life isn't to play in this club. I want to write music. And to do that, I play here, I accompany singers at auditions, I play for dance classes, I do arrangements, I do anything I can just so I can keep on writing music.
Boy, we're prepared to give you $2,000 right here, right now.
Daddy!
Just call this sorry excuse for a wedding off.
Mr. Spencer, Beth and I are getting married. We hope it's with your blessing. But we are getting married.
Well, the minister's ready.
Where's Evelyn?
Who's Evelyn? The minister, I suppose.
Oh, no, Evelyn is my wife. We have to seat her all the way in the back at weddings because of her sobbing, which I try not to take personally.
Let's start.
Elizabeth. Here's Grandma's ring.
Mama. Daddy.
At least she's not pregnant.
Good evening, everyone. Before the marriage ceremony, both Frank and Beth have asked to speak. Frank?
Beth, I'm so happy to be marrying you in the same place where I met you and grew to love you. And I'd like to thank all our friends for coming out here to celebrate this important day in both our lives.
Not a day goes by.
How's it going?
Good, you?
There.
Yeah, tell me.
Chinese laundry.
Hi.
Mary.
Say hello.
think I got a job.
Where?
True Romances.
Posing?
Thank you, writing captions.
What about the book?
What about the book?
Nothing. Are you working on the book?
Yes.
Good.
No.
Mary.
Right, I know. Yes, me and Balzac.
One act.
Got an audition.
I started the story.
Rehearsal pianist.
So where are we eating?
I'm moving to Playboy.
The publisher called me.
I'm doing a rewrite.
My parents are coming.
I saw my fair lady.
I rewrote the rewrite.
I sort of enjoyed it.
I threw out the story.
I'm meeting an agent.
We'll all get together on Sunday. We're opening doors. Singing. Here we are. We're filling up days on a dime. That faraway shores. Looking not too far. We're following every star. There's not enough time.
I sent out the one act.
I started the story.
He said to come see him.
I dropped out of college.
I met this musician.
I'm playing in nightclubs.
There drew my one act.
I'm working for Rodolfo.
I grew up a ballad.
I finished the story.
We started the Christmas.
I threw out the story and then the musician. I'm moving to popular signs.
We're opening doors. Singing. Look who's here. Beginning to sail on a dime. That faraway shores. Looking very near. We haven't a thing to fear. We haven't got time.
How's it coming?
Good, you?
Done.
1 minute.
Amber Nevin.
Hi.
Mary.
Say hello.
I got another job.
Where?
Cheek.
That?
A brand new concept, pop-up pictures.
What about the book?
What about the book?
Did you give the publisher the book?
Yes.
Good.
No, look, Sam? I never finished.
Let me call you back.
Right. This is just a draft. Probably it stinks.
Right.
I haven't had the time to do a pop-up.
Please sing.
Right.
Who wants to live in New York? Who wants to worry the noise, the dirt, the heat? Who wants the garbage cans clanging in the streets? Suddenly I do. They're always popping their cork. I'll fix that line. The cops, the cabbies, the sales girls, up in sacks. Gotta have a real taste for maniacs. Suddenly I do.
That's great. That's swell. The other stuff as well.
It isn't every day he has to be this strong. But fellas, if a man, there's only one thing wrong. There's not a tune you can hum. There's not a tune you go bum 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 bidum. You need a tune to go bum 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 bidum. Give me some melody. Why can't you throw them a crumb? What's wrong with letting them tap their toes a bit? I'll let you know it's Stravinsky has a hit. Give me some melody. Oh sure, I know. It's not that kind of show. But can't you have a score that's sort of in between? Like play a little more, I'll show you what I mean.
Wants to live in New York. I've always hated the dirt, the heat, the noise. But ever since I met you,
I listen, boys, maybe it's me.
But that's just not a ha-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-boom melody. Write more, work hard, leave your name with the girl. Less avant-garde, leave your name with the girl. Just write a plain old mellow.
You're stopping rehearsals. I ran out of money.
We lasted one issue. My book was rejected.
The nightclub was raided. I have to start coaching.
My parents are coming.
They screwed up the laundry.
My wallet was stolen.
I saw the musician.
We're being evicted.
I'm having a breakdown.
We'll all get together on Sunday. They're slamming the doors. Singing, go away. It's less of a sail than a climb. At faraway shores, farther every day. We're learning to ricochet. We still have a lot to say.
You know what we'll do?
What?
We'll do a review.
What?
We'll do a review of our own.
What?
When?
Why?
When?
Not just songs, but stories, scenes, piano pieces, mine.
Yeah. Frankly, Frank.
Showcase of our own.
When?
The club's reopening.
We write a lot of new stuff.
We write old stuff.
What about the girl?
What about the girl?
Only that we're going to need a girl.
Well, Mary.
Thanks, I don't perform except at dinner. Who wants to live in New York? Who wants to worry the noise, the Jersey? Who wants the garbage cans? I can sing higher.
Thank you for coming. Next eight, please. Up a tone.
The cops, the cabbies, the sales girls,
up a tone.
You've gotta have a real taste for mania.
Thank you, you're hired.
I bet you.
I'm Frank.
I really thought I'd stink.
I'm Mary.
Charlie. By the way, I'm told the open Saturday.
What? Are you not serious?
Nobody's ready.
Apparently somebody canceled a booking.
The songs aren't finished.
Well, what about confidence? How will I learn all these numbers?
I'll bring you the copies of everything later this evening.
Okay, but I'll have to have you on Saturday.
Worry about it on Sunday. We're opening doors. Singing, here we are. With you in the face on a dime. And Norway Shores, looking not too far. We're following every star. This land of time.
What are you doing up here?
I don't know. Just came up here.
Oh, well, you could have told a person.
You were asleep.
The alarm just went off. You see anything yet?
Uh-uh.
Something wrong?
No.
What are you doing up here so early?
I couldn't sleep. Charlie, I read your two plays last night. They were so wonderful, I couldn't sleep.
I thought you were mad. I have to tell everyone who comes over, always wake me whenever you think I'm wonderful.
I tossed and turned, thinking about wasting these last 2 years of the army, but to come back and read your plays.
Wasting? What about that music you played for me? Talk about wonderful.
Really?
Yes. Frank, you don't just write what you know. You write what you know.
Okay. This play, Pretty Politics, about the Senate pages. What do you think about making it into a musical?
Go on.
I got a better title. Take a Left.
That's a better title?
I think it's important. Musicals are popular. They're a great way to state important ideas. Ideas that can make a difference. Charlie, we could change the world. Something is stirring, shifting ground. It's just begun. Edges are blurring all around, and yesterday is done. Feel the flow, hear what's happening, we're what's happening. Don't you know we're the movers and we're the shapers? We're the names in tomorrow's paper. Up to us now.
and a show on. It's our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to win. Our turn coming through. Me and you, man, me and you.
Oh, my. We just wanted to see my roommate and... Oh, excuse me.
She's probably from Barnard. Barnard girls are dippy.
What time is it?
5:45. Say, you ever think about getting married?
No.
Me neither. When I'm a lot older, maybe.
Feel how it quivers on the brink.
What?
Everything. Gives you the shivers, makes you think. There's so much stuff to say. And you and me will be singing it like the birds. Me with music and you the words. Tell them things they don't know.
Up to us, pal, to show up.
It's our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to win. Our turn, we're what's new. Me and you, pal, me and you. Feel the flow, hear what's happening. We're what's happening. Long ago, all we had was that funny feeling. Saying someday we'd send a reeling. Now it looks like we can.
Someday just began.
It's our heads on the block. Give us room and start the clock. Our dreams coming true, me and you, pal, me and you, me and you.
Am I too late?
No, not at all, just about now.
My roommate Evelyn is coming up too.
Well, I'm Charlie Kringus, and this is Frank Shepherd.
I'm Mary Flynn.
We just took the apartment on 5.
I'm not officially moved in until I get discharged from the army next week. Oh, here. You can see best from about here.
Frank just got a weekend pass to help us move in. A lot to move in, a typewriter, 2 mattresses, a piano.
Are you the one playing the piano these past 2 days?
We're evicted.
Oh no, you're wonderful. Sincerely wonderful.
I'm sincerely grateful.
I even came up on the roof to hear you better. I'd tell everything then go home and suffer. Are you sincerely wonderful too?
Oh, I don't know.
He is. Charlie writes.
Me, Columbia, him, Juilliard.
That's what I want to do, right? But how does anybody compose music, though? To me, that is the gift of gifts.
I just met the girl I ought to marry. Did anyone ever tell you? You say all the right things.
Never. But I really want to know.
Well, writing music, it isn't about words. It's about sounds and feelings and... To me, music is everything.
Anyway... It's so creative.
If I didn't have music, I would die.
You know, someday Frank is going to be a very important composer.
He is. I think you already are.
Oh. Well, we should look now. We should come right about now.
You see anything?
I hope we didn't miss it. Should be over. There! There it is!
I see it!
Where?
There! There it is!
It's just phenomenal.
Phenomenal.
Don't you wish it was ours?
It's everybody's.
Do you call it Sputnik or Spootnik?
Call it a miracle.
God, we have to be the luckiest people who ever lived.
after this moment that the three of us are sharing here together, nothing's ever gonna be the way it was. Not ever again. Do you guys realize that now we're going to be able to do anything, I mean anything we ever dreamed of? What a time to be starting out. What a time to be alive. Something is stirring, shifting ground. It's just begun.
Edges are blurring all around, and yesterday is gone.
Feel the flow, hear what's happening.
We're what's happening.
Don't you know we're the movers and we're the shapers? We're the names in tomorrow's papers. Up to us how to show up. It's our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to win. Our turn coming through. Me and you, now me and you. Years from now, we'll remember and we'll come back. By the rooftop and hang a plaque. This is where we began. Being what we can. It's our heads on the block. Give us room and start the clock. Our dreams coming true. Me and you, now me and you. Me and you, me and you.